I won't just survive, or you will see me thrive. Can write my story. I'm beyond the archetype. I won't just conform, no matter how you shake my core. 'Cause my roots, they run deep. Whoa, I'll use only the pain. Don't doubt it, don't doubt it. Victory is in my veins.
Welcome, everybody. I am Steve the Gamble, and this is War, and this weekend is going to be hell. This day, today, we have a nice little selection of matches. We have David defending his international belt against the very openly media, social media frenzy man there, Carho, out there spreading his wares, talking about his desires and his goals. We also have Collier and Love Durant going at it, and Trable defending his hot seat belt against the one. But I'd like to say something during this entrance. We have certain people that we promote in this Fed. We put money into them. We put time into them. We promote them. And yet, they don't seem to return any effort. And there's one of them. They don't make any effort to promote us, which is promoting them. And it just seems like a bit of a slap in the face, certain people, who cry that no one wants to help them, and yet here we are helping them, but they haven't even mentioned us. So, you know who you are if you're watching this. You have to stop crying on social media that no one wants to help you if you're not helping those that are actually helping you. You know who you are. There are people here that share our stuff, like our stuff, comment on our stuff. But some of you don't do absolutely nothing. Nothing. And you cry that no one helps you. But here's someone that actually does help us. He is the River Monster. He likes us, shares us, comments on us, does promos. He does it all. And that is why he is the international champion. He has won a gold for a long time. He had tag gold before, but this is special because this is international gold. This is one of the good belts. David Rivera, he is promoted and pushed. He hopes to break records. And he has the ability to do it, folks. Let's be honest, he has the ability to do it. Ken Carho put a little effort into this match and win international gold from David Rivera. Hell, maybe cause a disqualification, do something. We will see. Look at that. Brand new and fancied up. Representing the NCC. This weekend, as you know, I put my job on the line. But I don't really worry about it too much because, well, we all know I have quite a winning record against a certain silent individual who spoke up, but I don't think he caught the joke. The one time he said something, otherwise, no. But here we have David Rivera. He does not want to lose to the waistcoat champion. He is the international champion. This is one of the more prestigious belts. It is defended a lot more often, but in fair play. Carho, ready to put all the effort he can into this match. He's a member of the roster. He's a member of the page. Yet, I don't think he knows he's there. You've heard of silent partners. Well, he's a silent roster member. But Dave Rivera cracks him over his knee. Carho. Carho has a few similar moves that David has. With his flamboyant style. Oh! Not quite David's style. Oh, David's a river monster. And he plans on holding on to that belt a good long time because title shots don't come around every day, regardless of how many we have. And whoa, shining wizard. Oh, yes, I'm harsh on people, but people like the clowns and the bosses, they want in. Or they accept the offer. But you don't understand that this is a two-way promotion kind of, whoa, belly-to-belly. Two-way promotion kind of a deal. We promote you, you promote us, and we're promoting you. Now we promote you, and you do nothing but cry that no one's promoting you. Oh, soaring clothesline. We're putting money into you, but you're not putting anything into us. Which would be putting into you again. But you're not doing that. And I've even approached him. I told him as subtly as possible, without being rude, what he needs to do, and I don't think he's getting it. I think he poked himself with his sewing kit a little too often. David trapped in, has him trapped in the corner. Oh! And, oh, down he goes. And rolls him up tightly in the turnbuckle. One, two, oh. Well, we didn't expect much differently. David made the effort, and Carho did not. But I look forward to bringing in our special guest announcer, as I will be in a match at the end of the weekend. And then you probably, well, I'm guessing we won't see Scott. He may come back. You never know. You never know. But he says he quits if he loses. And I don't plan on losing. Obviously. But now we're going to move on to the next match. Get it all settled up. We move on to the next match. I Love to Rant and Chris Collier, longtime brothers, and now they are at odds, and things are going to be resolved finally. But who will come out on top of this? The vaping vegan, the redeemed hoodlum himself, Chris Collier, or I Love to Rant, the rant master himself? It seems like... Oh, well, here's the music. And we'll see who comes out first. It is... There he is. I love to rant. He is coming out first. He wants to resolve this situation, if not just give it closure and move on. But is there room enough for both of these brothers? Wait, he's coming out a bit prematurely. Does he even know he's back there? Oh, right in the back there. Oh, no. Oh, he's just got him from behind. Well, I guess that gets him back for what he did to him out of the blue. But the Vaping Vegan, oh, he's just clobbering him with those giant meat hooks. Oh, he's tossed him down. He's still in his entrance gear. Oh, he's fighting back. And, oh, and he lost that advantage. Chris Collier, full of something. Maybe it's the vapes. I don't know. Oh, and against the wall. Uh-oh. Ow, and hung up on the edge of that. That does not feel good. I've been there. Oh, no. It hasn't even started. He's already going at him. Oh. Oh, no. Oh, that's not where that goes. Collier smashing the hammer in all areas. Oh, and he's got him at the wall, and he's just cornering him. Oh, and then beating him down. Oh, dear. Everyone's just sharing this behavior. I don't know. He is on fire. Where there is vape, there is fire. Oh! I love Durant stripped down to his ring gear. Which basically is street clothes, everybody. Oh, now the bell rings. Oh, no. I love Durant is... Oh, speared down hard. And there's a replay from another angle. Boom. And going for the pin. One, two... No, I love Durant still has something left in him. I would be a pile of garbage by now. Chris Collier is a machine, and oh no, this is not very Sunday of him. Wow. He is a different man. I think I love Durant open up a can of worms, and oh, he's going to be opened up like a can of worms. Thrown to the other turnbuckle. Whoa, and down he goes. Stamping on his back. Oh! Before he can even get fully up, he is clotheslined down. And Collier giving him a little space by referee's orders. And oh, we're going for the jackhammer. Oh, this is not going to be good for I Love to... Oh, wow. A little showing off there. One, two, three. Oh, he tried to get out of it, but he was down and out. Well... I love Durant. Wait, he's going back out now. He's going out. He's not had enough. Oh! I've never seen him do that. People are not liking this at all. And gives him one more good clobber. Just staring at his work. And the referee going out of the ring. Chris
Oh, he's going back for more. And the referee runs back in and tries to get him off I Love Durant. I Love Durant is badly damaged. He is out of it. Well, he's leaving him alone now. Wait, what's he doing? He's going back in with a chair. This is ridiculous. Oh my God, he's taking out his... Oh! And he's holding that arm down and... Oh, smashing it. He is obliterated. And they're wheeling out the gurney. I Love Durant. He is definitely on the shelf. When you see a gurney, you know it's bye-bye time. Well, we'll see you later, I Love Durant. And wait, oh, it's going after him again? Come on. Collier, what is in those vapes? Oh. Well, we move on. They'll clean up that mess. And we move on to the one's first attempt at the hot seat title. Trey Silent has held on to that title like it was... What was the name? I can't remember the name. He calls something... Calls his lantern Lulu Bell or something. But he has enjoyed his hot seat reign. People have tried and people have failed. And there is the one, Mark Kennedy. He has been tag champion extraordinaire. He has been international title holder. And now he is going for hot seat gold for the first time ever. He has been a single star tag team expert, but he has been a single star. With all those singles goals out there, he wants to go around the gamut. Quite a few people being able to claim three gold success. And this is his first shot at going for that third gold. Jeffrey Allbitten, one of the first to do so. Mike Miner has done it. Adam Oliver. Tag Team International. No, he's only got the two, I think. I'm not sure. And we're going to see what goes on here. And there he is. Hot seat champion. Him and Mike Miner going back and forth. Yeah, Mike Miner's a triple crowner. Because he's had hot seat, definitely. He's had international, definitely. And now he is a tag team star. So he's one of our triple crowners. But he's going up against a legacy. He's going up against history. The one is one of the classiest wrestler, E-Fed wrestlers there is. Regardless of what anyone says, my stats tell me that the one is indeed the one. This will be an anything goes kind of a deal. It's hot seat, folks. Might as well be called hardcore. Trey Silent, very proud of that gold. He has never gone against the likes of the one. But has the one never gone against the likes of Trey Silent? Pardon me, but there's a flu going around. And ding, ding, ding. Oh, Trey Silent taking an interesting approach. Oh, that did not work. Oh, he threw him off. Oh, but he got the post in the end. And, oh, and down he goes. And the one, dragon leg screw something. And the one throwing him, into the post. He's gonna bust that mask. Trey Silent, take control, and throws him against that post. First blood match could go this way. Think Bop Bop with blood. That doesn't make him win, though. This is a hot seat belt match, not a first blood. And going into his bag of tricks. And oh my goodness! Hot seat just got hotter, and the ladder. Trey Silent throws him away. And he pulls him back. Clotheslines him, Trey Silent down, and misses with a kick, and Trey Silent. Over the shoulder, suplex. Oh my God. Like a rag doll. But the one coming back and smashed his left leg all over that ladder. By the way, it's the first that's really been used. The Trey Silent jaw jacked. and Trey Silent jaw jacking. And he misses with that drop kick, whatever that was supposed to be. And the one crunches him over his knee and Russian leg sweep. The one, taking a hot seat outside of the box, so to speak. And elbow to Trey Silent's head. Setting him up for something. Is this? Thought it was going to be Vunderbar, but no, this will do just as much. Sidekick down, and does that do it? One, two. The one! The one has won the one hot seat belt. That was the move that finished it off. Boom, right there. But all that work outside the ring probably wore down the champ, the former champion now. And the one has joined the ranks of triple gold winner. And the one receiving his third title, different title. Congratulations, one.